10 more mistakes. Number one, very, very, very common mistake. They never do it by their own. Now, this is a mistake which a lot of students make, and it's a confusion between at least two different expressions. And the expressions both mean alone. This is what the student wants to say. They never do it alone. They never do it on their own, or they never do it by themselves. And what the student is doing is mixing up the last two expressions. When you can use either of them, but don't mix them up. It's on their own or by themselves, but it's not a mixture of the two. Okay? My son always says, I did it by my own self. So he also says it wrong. He's very little, but he also mixes up these two in a slightly different way from my students. But a lot of people make mistakes with this particular expression. Okay, number two, he was looking similar to them. Now, the main problem here is this verb, to look. It is a state verb, especially in this situation when we're talking about what somebody looks like. Look like is a state verb. And so here you don't say, you never say he was looking like a Frenchman or he was looking like my friend. It must be simple, not continuous. So he looked similar to them. If we're talking about appearance, we have to use simple. It's a state verb, look like. If you're talking about look at, I agree that look at is dynamic. I am looking at the painting. I was looking at the painting when my friend called. That's fine in continuous, but this is not okay in continuous. It's a state verb. Okay, number three, Watson suggested her psychological help. Now, this is when Watson is saying to one of the characters in the show, would you like some psychological help? Now, that is not a suggestion. That may surprise you. That's not a suggestion. A suggestion is a plan. What Watson did is offered her psychological help. She offered the patient some psychological help, or she offered the girl in the show psychological help. Because offer is when you have something to offer. It's some kind of help that you say, would you like this? Would you like me to carry your cases? He offered to carry my suitcase. Would you like me to open the window? He offered to open the window. But suggest is a plan. I suggested having Chinese last night, something like that. Okay, number four, didn't you see this film? Should be a question mark there, shouldn't there, really? No, definitely not correct. When we're talking to someone, and we mean in their whole life, have you ever seen this film? You have to use present perfect for this, you really do. Not didn't, but haven't you seen this film? And it's because you mean, have you ever seen this film? Haven't you seen this film one time in your whole life? You're actually referring to the whole of the person's life from when they were born until now. And so we always say, have you seen this film? Have you read this book? Have you met this person? Have you heard of this pop group? Okay, number five, I would better go and fix my table. The main problem here is this word, and I hope you all know that we use had better, not would better. Because we often shorten it to I'd better go and fix my table. That's what you usually hear. You just hear I'd. But remember that that is a had, not a would. Yeah, I had better go and fix my table, because had better means should. Exactly the same as should, and it is plus infinitive without to. Okay, number six, he found out that his central heating system broke. Very close to being correct, but the problem is tenses. When did the central heating system break? Well, it broke before he found out. Logically, it must have happened before he found out. So we need had broken. He found out that his central heating system had broken. He went into the room and he saw water everywhere. So he found out that his central heating system had broken. Number seven, here are all the evidences. Unfortunately, evidence is uncountable. And so you can't say here are all the evidence. You have to say here is all the evidence. Okay. Number eight, when they went to the party, they were seeing a t-shirt. Now, this is a mix-up of two tenses, this one and this one. The student was talking about a TV show, IT Crowd, and when they were on their way to the party, they saw a T-shirt. So the seeing is the quick part. They saw a T-shirt. That's the short action. It's not worth seeing. That's the short action. That should be past simple. But the going is a long action. Yeah, it takes a long time to get from your house to the party, and seeing the T-shirt is just a quick moment. Oh, look, there's the T-shirt. So when they were going to the party, they saw a T-shirt. Okay, this is the long action. This is the short action, past continuous, past simple. Number 9, what I have done last week, and that's the important signal. You should remember your signal words. I can't emphasize enough that signal words help you with your tenses. Last week is always past simple. If we know when, it's always past simple. What I did last week. Last one, number 10, he makes them to share his ideas. Now, anybody who watches this series has probably already seen this mistake a few times, maybe even very recently. So I hope you can immediately say, get rid of to. Because make someone do something doesn't have a to plus infinitive. It's no to. There's no to there with make, like force someone to do something. So my parents made me do my homework, or he made me, I don't know, stay at home, but it must be without to. Okay, if you have any questions about any of these mistakes, please ask them under the video, and I hope to see you all soon. Thanks for watching.